In this video lecture, we will study boundary value problem and a special kind of boundary value problems known as Sturm-Liouville problem and Sturm theory for second order ordinary differential equations. So, firstly, I'll start with second order boundary value problems. So, in short, we will write BVP. So, this is a typical example of second order equation. Is you have a second order problem y double prime PXY plus QXY equal to 0 if homogeneous and equal to f of x if you have a non-homogeneous equation. Okay, so if this f is 0, so you have a homogeneous equation, and if f is non-zero, you have a non-homogeneous problem. So with boundary conditions, with boundary conditions, shortly we will write BC. So y at A equal to y 0 and y at B equal to y 1. So we have two conditions, boundary condition at A and B. These conditions may be, they involve derivatives or they have mixed conditions, so that we will study later on. So you may have condition y dash A equal to something or y dash B equal to something as well. So ultimately you know solution or its derivative at two points A and B, and these points are called boundary points. So I am taking one example. So question is, solve the following boundary value problem. Y double prime plus 2y equal to 0 with boundary condition y at 0 is 1, at y at pi is also 0. So this is second order differential equation, y double prime plus 2y equal to 0, and we know that how to solve this. So we write its auxiliary equation, so that will be r square plus 2 equal to 0. So you have two roots, plus minus under 2 iota. So we are assuming solution in the form of y equal to e power r x, and roots are imaginary, so you have solution in term of sine or cosines. So solution is y of x equal to some constant cos of root 2x plus some constant sine of root 2x. So constant coefficient equation, so solution are e power rx. So now we apply boundary condition. So we use boundary condition. So first, y at 0 is 1. So this will give you fit x equal to 0. So c1 cos 0 plus c2 sin 0 equal to 1. So cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0. So c1 equal to 1. Second boundary condition, y at pi equal to 0. That will give you c1, you know already this. So this is 1. Cos of root 2 pi plus c2 sine of root 2 pi equal to 0. So this will give you c2 equal to minus cos upon sine. So minus cot under 2 pi. So unique solution is y of x equal to c1, which is 1, cos of root 2x plus c2 minus cot of under 2 pi. And cot root 2 pi is nearly minus 0.2762, and sine of root 2 x. So this is a unique solution of given boundary value problem. So now we take one more example. So this example tells us that you cannot always find all the constants. So solve of the boundary value problem. Y double prime plus y equal to 0. Y at 0 is 1 and y at pi equal to a. So where a is any given number, so any real number. So this is again constant coefficient equation, so solution will be in the form of Rx. So if x is independent variable, if t is independent variable, then y equal to e r t. So solution is, so you can write initial equation which will be r square plus 1 equal to 0. So you got r equal to plus minus iota. So solution is c1 cos x plus c2 sin x. So now apply boundary conditions. First condition is y at 0 equal to 1. So this will give you c1 cos 0 is 1, c2 sin 0 is 0. So this is c1 equal to 1. Second boundary condition, y at pi equal to a. So c1 is 1 already. So you have cos of pi plus c2 sin pi equal to a. So sin pi is 0, so this is 0, so you are not getting a. So a, you are getting in fact a. A is minus 1. So if a equal to minus 1, solution is yx equal to, so c1 1 cos x plus c2 sin x, and solution depend on c2, so this, and c2 is any arbitrary constant, so you got solution which is not unique. And if a not equal to minus 1, this problem has no solution. So depending on the situation, you may have unique solution, you may have family of solutions, or you may, so you don't, may not have any solution. So now we study some special kind of boundary value problem which are known as Sturm-Liouville problem. Firstly, I am defining, so they are also known as eigen value problems. So recall from algebra, so you have a matrix equation Ax equal to lambda x. So in the same manner, in differential equation, you have A is a differential operator. And acting on y, so you are getting y times something. So this matrix equation which is Ax equal to lambda of x, this equation may have solution x for every value of lambda, and that non-zero solution is called eigen vector, and that lambda is called eigen value. So situation is similar for differential equation as well. They are also known as eigenvalue problem, and solution is called eigenvector, and that lambda is known as eigenvalue. So I am taking one example. So for example, solve of the following boundary value problem. So we will have one unknown now. So y double prime. Okay. And this is boundary value problem. Y at 0 and y at pi both are 0. So if I compare with matrix equation, so you can write y double prime equal to minus lambda of y, or you can say d2 by dx square y equal to minus lambda of y, or you can say ay equal to minus lambda of y, or sometimes some text sort, so minus of ay equal to lambda of y. So a is a differential operator d2 by dx square. So solution, non-zero solution of this problem, so non-zero solution y, so y non-zero, this is called eigen vector, and the lambda for which you get non-zero solution, this is called eigen value. Okay, so now ultimately we will solve this problem and find the value of lambda for which you get non-zero solution. So we have y double prime plus lambda of y equal to 0, and depending on lambda you may get solution in term of sine or cosine, or solution in exponential form. So you can take three cases separately. So we consider three cases separately. So one is positive 0 and negative lambda, because from three cases you will get different function, sine, cosine, exponential or some polynomial. Okay, so firstly I am taking lambda positive, and for simplicity you can write a positive number as lambda equal to k square. So then you have y double prime plus k square y equal to 0. So this k square will simplify your calculation, that's it only. So you can take lambda as well. So the characteristics equation will be r square plus k square equal to 0. So auxiliary equation or characteristic equation will be this. Okay. So r equal to plus minus iota k. Okay, so general solution is y equal to c1 cos of kx plus c2 sin of kx. Now use boundary conditions. Y at 0 equal to 0, this will give you c1 equal to 0, and y at pi is 0, this will give you c2 sin k pi equal to 0. So now I have two possibility, either c2 is 0 or sin k pi, that can be also 0 sin. But if c2 is 0, you get only 0 solution, and in fact problem is homogeneous, so this will have 0 solution, but we are interested in non-zero solution. So if c2 is non-zero, so sin k pi will be 0. If sin k pi will be 0, so k pi will be some multiple of pi, and n is integer plus minus 2, etc. Okay, so you got k equal to n, and hence lambda equal to k square, so n square, and now n is 1, 2, 3. Okay, so negative will be positive. So this value of lambda, m square, which will be 1, 4, 9. So these are the eigenvalues. Okay, so eigenvalues are, lambda 1, first is 1, second is 4, dot dot etc. So lambda n is n square etc. And the corresponding solution, or we say eigenvector, corresponding solution is, so what is solution? Y1 equal to, so C1 cos X, C1 is 0, so C2 sin, so solution is, so corresponding solution or eigenvectors are y1, so solution will be sin nx, so this will be sin x and second will be sin 2x and sin nx etc. So solution is multiple of sin nx, so in general you can write c times sin nx. So that was the case for lambda positive. Now we take lambda equal to 0. So what will happen? So now you have equation equal to y double prime equal to 0. So on integrating, so this is d2y by dx square. So solution will be c1x plus c2. And use boundary condition y at 0. This will give you c2 equal to 0. And y at pi, this will give you c1 equal to 0. So only trivial solution y equal to 0 we are getting for lambda equal to 0. So third case is lambda negative. So we can write any negative number equal to lambda of minus k square. Okay, so this minus k square is just written for simplicity, nothing else. So so equation is y double prime minus k square y equal to 0 and characteristic polynomial will be r square minus k square equal to 0. So you got r equal to plus minus k. So solution is y equal to c1 e power kx plus c2 e power minus kx. So solution will be exponential form. So use boundary condition y at 0 is 0, this will give you c1 e power 0 is 1, so c1 plus c2 equal to 0, or c2 and c1 they are of opposite signs, and y at pi, this will give you c1 e power k pi and c2 will be minus c1 e power minus k pi equal to 0, so c1. So you can take c1 common, so this implies c1 equal to 0. C1, so this also give you c2 equal to 0. So only y equal to 0, only trivial solution for lambda negative. So in other words, this problem don't have negative or zero eigenvalue. So in other words, this problem has only positive eigen values, as you are getting solution only for lambda positive. So finally, solution is, so yx equal to some constant cn sin nx. So you can put a label y. Okay. And lambda, so that, and eigenvalues. So finally, so, and eigenvalues are n square. And eigenvectors are आइगन वेक्टर्स आर साइन एंड एक्स. ओके सो फाइनली सो द वैल्यू ऑफ लैम्डा फॉर विच यू गॉट नॉन जीरो सोल्यूशन दे आर कॉल्ड आइगन वैल्यू एंड द कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग नॉन जीरो सोल्यूशंस दे आर कॉल्ड आइगन वैक्टर्स और आइगन फंक्शंस. So since differential equation solutions are functions, so some we say eigenvectors or more generally we say eigenfunctions. So now I move to special kind of boundary value problem. So they are known as Sturm, Liouville problems. And shortly we will write SLP, Sturm-Liouville boundary value problems. So this is a special kind of differential equation. So we write L of y equal to lambda rx y. So what is L of y here? So L is a differential operator minus d by dx. Px dy by dx plus qx y. So what is Sturm-Liouville problem? So finally minus d by dx. So this is a second order differential equation having a special form plus qx y. So this is L of y equal to lambda Rx y. So if you compare with the standard matrix equation, so A of y equal to lambda Ry. So you have a function R on the right hand side. So for any x, so plus you have some boundary conditions and the functions. The functions, so you have p, okay, so also you have p dash x indirectly if you differentiate by parts, you have qx and rx, so all are continuous on interval, some interval ab. And px is positive, rx is positive or it can be 0 on ab, on some interval ab. And we also have boundary conditions on this problem. So shortly we write boundary at a. Okay, so alpha 1 y at a plus some beta 1 coefficient y dash at a equal to 0 and another boundary at b, this is alpha 2 y at b and beta 2 y dash at b equal to 0. So alpha 1, beta 1, alpha 2, beta 2, these are constant, they may be, some of them may be 0. So you have two boundary condition, one at A and one at B. So we have mixed boundary condition. Okay, so if beta I are 0, so what you got? Only y at A and y at B. So these are called Dirichlet boundary condition. So only function value at A and B. So you got y at A 0 and y at B equal to 0. And if alpha i's are 0, alpha 1, alpha 2 both are 0. So these are called Newman boundary condition. So in that case you have y dash A is 0 and y dash b equal to 0. So these are Newman boundary conditions. Okay, and if you alpha 1, beta 1, alpha 2, beta 2 all are non-zero, so we have mixed boundary conditions. So these SL problems, and in fact their solutions, has a rich structure, and further we will see that we will construct Fourier series from the solution of these equations, and they are widely used in many areas of mathematics, physics and other engineering branches. So an example of these type of problems are many, so I am writing one example. So for example, you have y double prime equal to lambda of yx, okay, so y at 0 and y at some l is 0. So this is a simple SL problem. So here we have taken px is 1, qx is 0 and rx is 1. Okay, so this is the example of Sturm-Liouville boundary value problem. And there are three types of Sturm-Liouville problem. So number one, Sturm-Liouville problem is called regular if px is positive and rx is positive. So they are positive but rx is not 0. So, but qx can be any number. So, then we say problem is regular. And Sturm-Liouville problem is called periodic if px is positive, rx is again positive, and p, q, they are continuous functions on AB along with periodic boundary conditions. So periodic means, so y at A equal to y at B and y dash A equal to y dash B. So this is a simple example of periodic boundary conditions. So a regular problem can be periodic if you have periodic boundary conditions. So y at equal to y at b and y dash a equal to y dash b. And number three, the Sturm-Liouville problems are called singular if it is neither regular or nor periodic and coefficients may have singularity. Okay, so singular problems are difficult to study as their coefficients has singularity. So may coefficient may not be analytic, they may not be defined somewhere in domain. So most common type of SL problems are, so that are used, so they are regular and they are periodic. And these two problems we study in detail in this topic, and you, as you have seen, that these are second order differential equations. So if you expand the first term, you will get second derivative. So now I am going to state one basic result which says that you can transform any second order differential equation of the form. So let us say you have a second order equation in this form. Okay, so equal to fx. So any second order differential equation of this form can be put into the following Sturm-Liouville form. So d by dx px dy by dx plus qxy equal to f of x. So where px is e exponential, so a1 by a2 both are functions of x dx, and what is qx? This is px a0 upon a2, and what is fx? This is px fx upon a2x. And here you a1 is function of x and a2 is also a function of x. So you can transform any second order differential equation into Sturm-Liouville problem. So there is no negative sign that can be adjusted. So some texts say that this is Sturm-Liouville problem. So there is no problem. So proof is quite simple. So you have a second order. So we have second order differential equation a2x y double prime plus a1x y prime plus a0x y equal to f of x. So firstly divide with a2, provided it, and a2 is non-zero since you have a second order equation. And if a2 is 0, so you don't have second order equation. So you can divide with a2. Okay? Equal to f of x. And of course this is also divided with a2x. Okay, so now we multiply with, now multiply this equation with mu. And actually what we want to do, we don't want y dash explicitly in this equations. Okay, as Sturm-Liouville problem, they don't have first derivative directly. So we want to club second and first derivative. So first multiply this equation with mu. This is something similar to integrating factor. So mu of x y double prime plus mu x. So I'm writing a1 upon a2. So both are functions of x. And mu a0 upon a2 and fx upon a2. Okay. So now what I want to do, I want to combine these two. Okay. So how I can combine? So the first two ratios, first two terms can be combined into an exact derivative means exact derivative, so mu y dash, okay, dash. And if you differentiate, what you got? And if the second coefficient if the second coefficient is mu dash x. So this means what is mu dash x? Mu x a1 upon a2. Okay, so if you expand this mu y dash, so that will be mu y double dash first term, then mu dash y dash, that will give you second term. So if coefficient is this, so then your problem is solved. And from this OD you can get mu dash by integrating. So on integrating, what will be mu x? Mu x will be e raised to power a1 upon a2x dx without any constant on integrating. Okay, so the given equation can be multiplied by a factor mu by a2, so that is 1 by a2 e raised to power a1 upon a2 x dx, and this will turn your problem into Sturm-Liouville problem. Okay, so finally you can put given equation into compact form. So d by dx px y dash plus qx y equal to f of x. Okay, and this completes the proof. So by using that this result, you can turn any second order differential equation into a Sturm-Liouville problem. And in the theorem I have written notation mu x as px. Okay, so there is no problem. So you can apply this result to change any second order equation into Sturm-Liouville problem, and sometime you can do directly by a trick, just combine second and first derivative, that's it. So for example, convert this problem into Sturm-Liouville form. Sturm-Liouville form. Okay, so how you solve this equation? So you multiply with the mu x by a2. Okay, so what will be a2? So this will be 1 by x square, first divided by x square, and e raised to power. What will be mu x? E raised to power a1, which is 1. So dx by x. Okay, so you got 1 by x square, e raised to power log x. So x by x square, this is 1 by x. So multiply with 1 by x, or you can say divide with x. So you have xy double prime plus xy prime plus 2y equal to 0. So multiply with the integrating factor, or you can say divide. So divide with x, you got xy double dash plus y dash plus 2 by xy equal to 0. And now you can combine first and second term, that will be xy dash dash plus 2 by xy, and this is Sturm-Liouville form. वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, यू कैन ऑल्सो कन्वर्ट डायरेक्टली. सो वन मोर एग्जाम्पल, लेट अस ट्रांसफॉर्म दिस इक्वेशन. अल्फा अल्फा प्लस वन वाई इंटू स्टर्म लेवाल प्रॉब्लम. सो यू कैन अप्लाई ट्रिक और यू कैन अप्लाई डायरेक्ट रिजल्ट. सो आई कैन राइट दिस प्रॉब्लम एज वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर वाई प्राइम एंड देन प्राइम प्लस अल्फा अल्फा प्लस वन वाई. सो दिस इज स्टर्म लेवाल फॉर्म. ओके, सो वन माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर विल गिव यू माइनस टू एक्स सेकेंड टर्म. ओके, सो और यू कैन, इफ यू वांट टू गो डायरेक्टली, सो यू कैन राइट फर्स्ट राइट. सो व्हाट इज ए टू एक्स स्क्वायर. ए वन इज माइनस टू एक्स एंड ए जीरो इज अल्फा अल्फा प्लस वन. ओके, सो यू गॉट म्यू एक्स बाई ए टू एक्स वन बाई एक्स स्क्वायर इज टू पावर ए वन बाई ए टू. सो ए वन बाई ए टू, सो दिस इज वन बाई एक्स स्क्वायर ई रेज टू पावर माइनस टू बाई एक्स ई रेज टू पावर माइनस. सो इंटरनेट में फैक्टर जस्ट वन. सो नो, डोंट डू एनीथिंग. ओके, and so the final form is minus x square y dash dash plus alpha alpha plus 1 y equal to 0. I think we have some problem in question here. So this is x square y double prime minus 2 x y prime. Okay, so okay. So here is a positive sign, so you cannot combine. Sorry. So this is just x square. Okay, this is a correct form. Okay. So I'm writing again. So what is the equation? So this is the equation x square y double prime plus 2xy prime plus alpha alpha plus 1 y equal to 0. So this is integrating factor is 1. So just write x square y dash dash alpha alpha plus 1 y equal to 0. And its derivative will be, of course, x square y double prime plus 2xy prime. And this is Sturm Liouville theorem. So basically you need to club the first and second derivative to get Sturm Liouville problem. And general result is that any second order, okay, second order OD can be converted into Sturm Liouville forum by using that result, or you can club the second and first derivative by using a trick.